Good morning, students. Now, last time we have discussed about the asexual reproduction. Today we are going to discuss about the sexual reproduction. Now, you are familiar with the modes of reproduction that depends on the involvement of two individuals before new generation can be created. You know that bulls alone cannot produce the calves, hens cannot produce the chicks. In such case, both the sexes, male and female, are needed to reproduce the new generation. So, what is the significance, importance of the reproduction? Why it is essential? Let us discuss. The creation of two new cells from one involves copying of DNA. What is the full form of DNA? Deoxyribonucleic acid. You know, it is one of the genetic material. As well as this cellular apparatus. The DNA copying mechanism, as we noted, that cannot be absolutely accurate because there is an error in copying all this DNA, and resultant errors are the source of variation in the population. You know that 100% copy of any person we do not get. There is some variations that are seen in the population. And every individual organism cannot be protected by variations. But in population, the variations are useful for ensuring the survival of the species. It would therefore make sense of organisms came up with reproductive modes, and that allowed more and more variations to be generated. Now, DNA copying mechanisms are not absolutely accurate. They are precise enough to make the generations of variation in fairly slow process. Copying mechanism, there will be less accurate. Many of the resultant DNA copies would not be able to work with cellular apparatus, and then die. So how we can the process of making variants be speeded up? So new variation is made in DNA copy that already has variations accumulated from previous generation. Thus, two different individuals in population would have quite different pattern of accumulated variations. Since all these variations, there are combining living individuals, it is assured that they do not have any really bad effects, and combining variations from the two or more individual would thus create new combination and of variants. The combination would be novel. Unka jo combination hota hai, bilkul alag hota hai, right? And since it would have involved two different individuals, the sexual mode of reproduction incorporates such process of combining DNA from two different individuals during reproduction. But this creates a major difficulty. If each new generation is to be the combination of DNA copies from two pre-existing individuals, then each new generation will end up having twice the amount of DNA than the previous generation. So likely to mess up the control of cellular apparatus of the DNA. How many ways can we think for solving this difficulty? We have seen earlier that as organism become more complex, the specialization of tissue increases. One solution that many multicellular organisms have found for problem mentioned above in the special lignins and cell office. Then the way which only half the number of chromosomes and half the amount of DNA. You know that every organism in human beings contain 46 chromosomes. The number that 23, half of the number of chromosomes that we get from mother and 23 from father, means number of chromosome means DNA becomes half. So here the amount of DNA as compared to the non-reproductive body cell, this is achieved by the process of cell division called meiosis. You know about the mitosis and meiosis. Thus, when these germ cells from two individuals combine during sexual reproduction to form a new individual, it results in establishment of the number of chromosomes and the DNA contained in the new generation. If the zygote is to grow and develop into an organism which has highly specialized tissue organs and then has no sufficient stores of energy for doing this. In very simple organisms, it is seen that the two germ cells are not very different from one another and may even be similar. But as the body design becomes more complex, the germ cell also specializes. One germ cell is large, contain the food stores, while the other small and likely to be motile. Conventionally, the motile germ cell is called the male gamete and the germ cell containing the stored food is called female gamete. We shall see in the next few sections how this need create these two different type of gametes give rise to differences in the male and female reproductive organs and some cases the differences in the bodies of male and female organisms. Now we discuss about the sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Flowering plants, okay? So that we take in next video.